I went and did the research. GMO is reducing our fertility. GMO is doing it in all the other animals they tested on. They won't let human tests go on because they want to cover this up. All the big eugenicists that call for population reduction are the ones funding it, like Bill Gates buying into Monsanto.
To talk about a new way, one that some of your listeners might be familiar with. There was a study, a series of analyses done on aborted fetal tissue of livestock where the farmer was beside himself. There was such high rate of abortions, spontaneous abortions. And on the aborted fetal tissue was a new organism only visible under with an electron microscope. And they figured out where is this stuff coming from. So they did analysis of the feed. And when the feed was treated with Roundup, either it was Roundup ready crops or products that had Roundup sprayed, there were high concentrations of this organism and high concentrations on diseased plants that are known to be getting disease because of Roundup.
What is it?
They took this organism and they exposed it to a pregnant chicken. It killed the fetus in 24 to 48 hours. Now, this organism has never been discovered before. It's completely new to science. It's the size of a virus. It operates, it looks like a fungus, and it appears to be everywhere, but in high concentrations around diseased plants and infertile animals and animals that have spontaneous abortions. So a letter was written by a senior researcher,
good Lord,
by a professor emeritus, in fact, Professor Dr. Don Huber,
good Lord,
who had decades of study and was an expert at Roundup effects. He was also on a military group that evaluates the threats of outbreak of disease, both natural and man-made. Mm-hmm. And in his letter to Secretary Vilsack of the USDA, he said this is an emergency. He pointed out that there is widespread infertility among animals, that there might be a human link, of course, and that Vilsack should not approve Roundup Ready alfalfa because that would only increase the exposure of the population to Roundup at a time when we need to put money now into investigating whether this organism is causing the problem and linked to Roundup or GMOs. He sent that letter on January 17th privately to Secretary Vilsack. It was leaked onto the internet, so that's why I can talk about it. He was finally called weeks later by someone from the USDA. He gave them the names of the researchers, and the researchers have not yet been contacted by the USDA, and that was over a year
ago. Let me stop you. I'm going to have you back up next week because this, we've only got 30 minutes left, 35 minutes before our next guest joins us. This is so bombshell because I research this stuff every day now, and I didn't even know what you're just saying here. But I knew about how it's basically creating new bacteria in the stomach and displacing the others, where I guess you won't be able to live without the Roundup now in some sick way. It's like they're turning us into these biological androids that are dependent on them and ill from their system, and then they sell us expensive treatments. But I've seen these reports of GMOs crossing and creating new mutations, but now in new, not just species, but new whole organism families. This is exactly what many genetic engineers I've had on, I just got chills, have warned of. And here's the key. We're going to come back and talk about this. They're not just coming out with dozens of new crops. They're coming out with hundreds of new ones, grasses, trees. They're just taking everything over. They're total psychos. Jeffery M. Smith's our guest. This is the most important information we could be covering right now. Incredible. If you're a new listener and you're thinking, man, this can't be true, I'm begging you, because I investigate things. That's where I get my views, my research, what I stand for. I've been researching GMO for about 16 years since I've been on air. And early on, I noticed it was eugenicist, world population reductionist, the very groups calling for global government and reducing population who are always running the programs to save people. And then wherever they go, there's famine, death, wars, destruction. And then I found Memorandum 200 and others. It's all a plan. But these people are so crazy that they're killing the honeybees, that the animals are dying. They're just screwing the whole earth up. I mean, it's bad enough to say, well, for the environment, humans are, you know, destructive. We're going to covertly reduce human population and then screw up the entire biosphere of the earth. I mean, even if you buy into this view, and I certainly know there are some technologies humans engage in and things that we screw up, we should make it better. But just kill everybody? And let's just say it's all a big accident. Okay, well, governments now know about this and are doing nothing. And, well, not in Europe and other areas, but here. Notice we have the highest cancer rate, the highest obesity rate, the highest everything rate that's bad. Highest infant mortality now in the Western world. I mean, highest heart attacks, highest neurological disorders, lowest test scores. Go look it up. I mean, look, I'm not a rocket scientist. When I feed my kids a few times on the road or something, just even some fast food junk, they act horrible for days. I give them processed sugar. They're bad for days. It's not just when they're on it. It screws them up. The dyes, the additives. And this is a cornucopia. I mean, if you were trying to covertly poison people, you couldn't do a better job. And then you see how it's almost uncoordinated. It's just like nasty, mean. And then they let other corporations that just don't care do whatever they want. Now, I'm ranting here, Jeffrey Smith. I want to give the number out and take some calls for you. 800-259-9231. 800-259-9231. We have all of your books available on the online video bookstore at InfoWars.com. Genetic Roulette, Seeds of Deception, your film, other films that you've been involved in, great films like The World According to Monsanto that you think's hardcore. It's very well done, but it's even worse than that. But I want you to continue. The toll-free number to join us is 800-259-9231 on this subject, folks. 800-259-9231. In fact, I should have said this because the calls will load now. And we won't have any room for others. I've done this before just by myself and called for farmers to call and said, have you had good luck with GMO? Have you had problems? And every farmer that calls who has livestock says, you feed it to them, they have health problems, they start dying. You start having more, calves that die, they're stillborn, more calves you got to pull. I'm not going to get into what that is, but I've worked for a large animal vet and done it. All of it. Some people that just grow soybeans or whatever say, no, it's all right. Neighbors don't like it, though. You know, they think the runoff's killing their fish and their tank. And that's about what you get. And, you know, the health problems with it in your drinking water. But going back to Mr. Smith here, the author, the researcher, other key points you want to cover here before you get into my main question. I think you answered it. The government just isn't even responding. How does the elite think they're going to get out of what they're doing to all of us when it's obviously affecting them as well?
It's an interesting question. When Obama took his position at the White House, an article came out indicating that he had insisted that his kitchen was organic.